I am the Rezzo, the sword of the king. It was here in the pits of the Theopolis that I made my name, killing red dogs and wild boars.
I can't do this just yet.
Sidr Aman. In this, so glorious of arenas, I care nothing for your past, only your future. And for that, you will have to fight.
They can't do this just yet.
People of the gutters, steel your bellies, for this slaughter is at hand.
Awaits.
My spirit is spent. They can't do this just yet.
Die a death worthy of applause, gladiator.
Thank you. age 13, carving knife in hand, I killed beasts for the amusement of the filthy. At 15, they thought me worthy to fight a fellow man. A butcher he was, twice as big and twice as stupid as I. I butchered the butcher, and many like him. Earned my way, kill by kill, out of the awful pit and into the grand arena. I thought I would find wealth and glory in the arena. I was wrong. I found something far more precious. My Lady Mervale.
Spirits are spent. I can't do this just yet.
I knelt in the sand of the Grand Arena, awaiting the killing blow. I raised my eyes to look upon my death. Instead, I saw her, Mervale. Her beautiful eyes met mine, and I knew she saw me too. I turned my opponent's strike and killed the man with his own dagger. Fighting had always been about survival. The primal instinct to kill or be killed. Now, the fight became about something else. Love.
I can't do this just yet.
A battle worthy of song. The way you fight reminds me of how it feels to be possessed with the idea of victory. Is your passion enough to claim a crown? We shall see.
The previous King of Swords was a giant of a man. Both faster and stronger than I. Yet I needed only look up at my Lady Mirveil to know that I had no choice. I could not die this day. I made him shiver under every parry, striking with all of my might so that my arms felt they might snap with every impact. All the while, I studied his face, watching for that moment when he began to doubt. It took an hour, but finally, it was there. Burning with pain, empty with exhaustion, I stepped inside his faltering swing, and I slit the giant's throat. I did not take my victory vow. I knelt in the sun, looked to Mirveil, and cried out for my lady's hand in marriage. From that day forth, I wore the crown of swords upon my head and the ring of eternal love upon my finger.
Thank you.
I can't do this just yet. Your glory will be remembered in song forever, Duresso. I promise you that. I believe in traveling light.
Let me tell your future. They run, they bite, they flee, they die. Swarms of fur and teeth and tail drown each and every room. The rings that bind grow tighter, the plate thicker, the leather denser, all with a single touch.
What do you want?
To plow a field, you need a tool. To harvest grain, you need a tool. To spread corruption, you need a tool. Wet and slippery flesh, clinging feet and tongue. No matter the color before, now the earth is green.
Pried the desire from Duresso's dead hand, did you? Or is it dead again hand? Or re-dead hand? Or is undeath really just death with benefits? In which case, you didn't kill Duresso because he was already dead. It's all a bit of a grey area, really. And completely beside the point. Yet we're still one gem short. Go, not a cockroach, and relieve Calm of his fury.
Eternals opened the gate and invited Kitava into this land. The Karui paid the price. Kitava cut us off from the ancestors, raised the remembered as his children, tortured our dreams. Kitava murdered the Karui way. I will found a new way, for I have been chosen. I gather my forces so that I might wage war on Kitava. I am the son of Tukuhama. And I will lead the Karui back to glory.
Do this just yet.
Thank you.
harvest is ready at last.
Perhaps not as thrilling as killing someone in cold blood.
soil of Rayclast you were infected. Kitava has soaked this land in his filth. I will crush the corruption from your bones. Drain your black blood upon this sacred ground. Brothers and sisters, I honor you with a warrior's death. Your spirits will fight by my side when we march against Kitava. You will be given in service to Tukohama. You will be remembered with glory.
Let me tell your future. The metal softens beneath the stone, reshaping with great ease.
Yes.
Fury and desire, together again. Lovely and lovely. Facets so shiny, replete with the vim of murdered souls. My Malachi did the crafting. Beautiful work. General Adis did the murdering. Equally beautiful work, in its own juicy way. Num Num's time, my little rapture. Have you ever been to the end of the world before, my king? Asked the blackest monkey. No, I have not, realized the monkey king. There is my reason to go where you go, be where you be, my king, concluded the blackest monkey in a voice as warm and welcoming as death. Do you know who wrote that? Not a cockroach? Victorio Navalius, the people's poet of Sarn. He was my friend, and I betrayed him. took his love and burned it before his eyes. Now I am betrayed. My heart burned black by the one man I loved. Malachi. He's found a new heart, you see. A beast's heart to cuddle up to keep him warm and safe at the end of the world. Today, I remind Malachi of his betrayal. Today, it is his turn to burn. Malachi's devices, his creations, he loved them all, not me. He betrayed me then, said he loved me, then said he wanted me to die. He betrays me now, lets me suffer, lets me wither. Am I the one and only mistake that you ever made, Malachi? Yes, that's me. Diala, the Gemling Queen. Malachi's misdemeanor. Make him regret his mistake. Not a cockroach. Tear open the beast's black heart. Rip Malachi from his filthy little nightmare. Cut him. Crush him. Burn him from existence. He deserves no better. And I deserve no worse. No love for me. No love. No love. No love.
I'm inside it. The beast itself. I can't do this just yet.
Our garden swells with life force.
can't do this just yet.
Thank you.
I can't do this just yet.
Crop is ready.
Oh, duelist, you're so cute when you're bewildered.
I can't do this just yet.
my beautiful champion. I knew I could rely on you. That's twice now I've experienced a little death with you, duelist. This time it was just the rude awakening I needed. When we shared our moment back in the Lunaris Temple, part of me wishes I'd died at your feet as intended. The little girl within me that shies from darkness, from greatness. It was Malachi who reached out to me, who wrapped me in nightmare, made me his slave. He has shown me greatness beyond imagining, so much that I thought my mind would shatter under its weight. And although my mind remains intact, my dreams were not so fortunate. Malachi is in the Beast's black core right now, harnessing all that the Beast is and will be. He will destroy this world and forge it anew in the divine image of Nightmare. Yet as powerful as Malachi has become, he is neither unreachable nor invulnerable. He sacrificed much to become the Beast's prime servant, both in spirit and in flesh, yet three vital organs remain. His heart, lungs, and entrails, keepsakes of humanity lost. They will be our tickets into Malachi's private little show. Venture deeper, deep into Nightmare's abattoir. I'll follow when I'm able. You find me those organs, and I'll get us into the Black Core. Malachi chose his three most loyal servants to guard those precious innards. His godless three. Inquisitor Malagaro, Chevron of Umbra, and Doedri Darktongue. If the history books are accurate, High Templar Vol burned Malagaro and Doedri at the stake on his way to lay siege to Sarn. He didn't have to worry himself with Chevron. Brutus had already sorted her out. Yet slaves of Nightmare seem to be shackled just as tightly to life as they are to the Beast. I, of course, am living proof of that. Don't worry yourself with that little detail, though. Shackles are made to be unlocked.
I can't do this just yet. This thing gets more twisted with every step I take.
What do you need now? The Gemling Queen has given of that black life of hers. For what? To wound and wake the beast that should have been slaughtered in its sleep. Diala's path would lead us into cataclysm. Follow your own path from now on.
Yes?
Do
Jiala saw the mistakes of the past with her own eyes, and now she's given everything to fix them. Right, Vanya?
I don't know, Petaris. I saw people die for each other in San. I saw clarity, resolution in their eyes. In Diala's eyes, I see ghosts.
Those eyes have seen horrors that we can't even imagine.
Maybe. But this sacrifice of hers, I think it was more like a deal, and Diala didn't quite get what she bargained for. Piety? She still lives.
Then she needs to die again.
Permanently this time. I honestly don't know who I am more scared of. The beast or that black-hearted witch.
It's the combination that scares me. And it should scare you too, Exile. You killed the Sword King?
Dereso wasn't actually alive, Petaris.
Dereso must have thought he was alive.
True. Thinking and being, a bit of a blurred line here in Rayclast.
Exactly.
Welcome.
What do you need now?
I see and feel the darkness. When a boil is fat with infection, it glistens with the luster of false youth. Lance that boil, and it weeps its corruption away and shrivels to nothing. Whether by purpose or desire, you are the physician who has revealed Diala's truest nature. Dereso was always a good man at heart, chained to an eternity of love and triumph. You set him free. Nightmare gave Coom everything he ever dreamed of. How did it feel to make that dream die? Beneath your feet, creation shivers and writhes. It yearns for transformation like a worm in a cocoon that dreams of wings and freedom. A transformation that only the beast can excite. A dark god of ancient sacrifice, a muse to the twisted and vile. The beast, the nightmare, the darkness, names given to it by mortals that think with slugs bound in shells of bone. Yet, one man knew the beast's true name, understood its impenetrable nature. Malachi. Upon death, our bodies return to the ground. Those that are marked with darkness nourish the corruption. Those that were mighty in life are stolen away. They are carved and crafted, manipulated with malevolent creativity into becoming Malachi's servants, forged into ghasts of pure nightmare. Malachi is what every ghast aspires to be. The hands and eyes, the voice and mind of the beast itself. I see him in my dreams, forming his designs, crafting his tools, refining the chaos of nightmare into a vision. A future that you and I would not recognize, that neither you or I belong to unless, of course, we choose to accept the dark embrace. This is Malachi's greatest work, an act of invention like none other. Should he succeed, he will awaken the beast. What then? The beast is not death. Life will go on, a life like nothing we have seen before. Ghasts have no use for words. To speak in nightmare is to speak in emotion and image, in thought. I see and feel the darkness, and that is how I know that the cataclysm was no accident. Its images are far too rich with intention, far too steeped in satisfaction. Malachi's satisfaction. Malachi devastated my people, destroyed the Eternal Empire for one reason. To put himself right where he is now, within the black heart of the beast. Malachi's apprentices, Chevron of Umbra, Dodre Darktongue, and Inquisitor Marigado, You'll find no more devoted servants in awe of nightmare and life. They were the three finest forgers of corruption in the Empire. I'm inclined to agree with Malachi on this one. It would have been such a waste to let them languish in death. Poor Deshret. Each had the wicked way with her, you see. Their turn at trying to subsume Deshret into the collective corruption. Ingenious they are. True artists. Had Deshret been in possession of an imagination, they might well have succeeded in creating a ghast of her. Fortunately for us, Deshret never had such a faculty.
Speak your mind. I am told that you have put King Calm down to his final rest. Cursebreaker, and now the murderer of legends. Great names hatch upon you like ticks on a roar. Diala's hopes may be crushed, but ours still thrive in you, Cursebreaker. From what Tasuni tells me, the beast's innards are now yours to penetrate. Diala has served her purpose. Now comes the time for you to serve yours. Find this Malachi that Diala mutters about so incessantly. If my understanding is true, then he is the mind of the beast. Kill him, and the body of Nightmare will die with him. Thank you for doing Deshret so great an honor. Your generosity shall be remembered.
What is that in your eyes? That glistening, that softness? Is that pity? Take those pitying eyes away before I pluck them from your face. I need but one thing from you now. Malachi. Dead. Take this. I've given everything else to him. My youth and beauty. My body and mind. My heart. And at last, the only thing he ever gave to me in return. My gemling power. This is all I have left. I entrust it to you. Not a cockroach. Malachi taught me not to trust anyone. It is time to forget everything that Malachi taught me. the little cockroach witch. Malachi chose her. Chose her over me. Use her then. Use her as Malachi uses her. Burn betrayal with betrayal. It's all they deserve. Still, I live.
Greetings. Greetings.
I can't do this just yet.
garden swells with life force. Come.
I can't do this just yet.
Considered trading the sword for a plow, Exile?
Oh, duelist, you're so cute when you're bewildered. My beautiful champion, I knew I could rely on you.
Thank you.
I can't do this just yet.
Before we walk this path together, it's important that you understand one thing about me. I don't regret a single thing that I've done. I set out to raise humanity up from the cloying mud of its fleshly ignorance. My mistake was not in the aspiration, but in the execution. Now I intend to correct that mistake. Really, I'm not helping you, Exile. You're helping me. So, have you found those juicy organs for me yet? Malachi knew exactly what he was doing when he created the Rapture. His primary concern, get inside the beast and take up the reins of true power. And his second objective, incite a cataclysm that would wipe the very thought of resistance from this land. The beast is the source of all thaumaturgy, the one power in this world that transforms what is real into what is imagined. The entire world is now at the mercy of one man's vision. It won't be the future I imagined, and it won't be the future you imagined either. While he remains within the Black Core, the only imagination that matters is Malachi's.
Spirit is spent. I didn't catch a word of what you said, Doedri. That's probably a good thing. I can't do this just yet.
You work fast. You know it is no mere freak of nightmare that fashioned that monstrous version of myself, the one you so kindly dispatched. The Godless Three took great pains in getting me looking just so. They were none too gentle about it either. So no need to play softly with the remaining two. Treat kindness with kindness.
What do you need now?
this day, the eve of this rapturous completion, I honor those who have passed and whose passion and knowledge have brought us to the brink of salvation. Inquisitor Maligaro, a creative force without equal. Chiron of Umbra, an athlete of transcendent sensibility. Duendri Dagdan, an idol of fervor and dedication.
I can't do this just yet.
You taught me far more than I ever taught you, my student. My friends, we strove to make a greater world together. And in your memory, I shall make that world a reality. Malachi.
Now you are simply gorgeous.
My spirit is spent.
The harvest is ready at last.
I can't do this just yet.
Dissection time. Greatest form I never sculpted.
Take comfort, Maligaro. An artist's work is always worth more when he's dead.
You, my champion, have caused me more pain than any other man in my life. Yet do you know from whence my true agony has originated? Not from the violence you have inflicted upon me. I'm a big girl. I can take it. No, it is having to look into those pretty eyes of yours across this chasm of creed that has separated us. Until this moment.
Yes.
Pleasure to finally meet you, duelist. You and I will create the most beautiful of nightmares together. Let us bathe you in blood, duelist, so that this world might be bathed in glory.
Now, exile! Now, exile!
Yet.
this is what I get for trying to be a bloody hero. An honest death. The only redemption I was ever likely to get. You know, it's a question that's always haunted me. Whose will be the last face I see? I like the answer. Go, my pretty champion. I want that fine ass of yours to be the last thing I see.
Oh, well, far be it from me to deny a lady's final wish.
Now, let us see if you truly understand what it means to be Nightmare.
I can't do this just yet. It's a strange feeling when the fighting is done. I've won. The nightmare has ended.
The beast is dead, and Rayclast owes you its life. Is this the grand ending you were hoping for, duelist? Yes, you must be very proud of yourself. What is it, Exile?
There's no arena, no trophy, no accolade, no title.
No end to what Pataras could spout in your honor.
In this case, I think it's all right to do so for a bit, don't you? We're standing in the presence of the greatest duelist that ever lived.
For once, I actually agree with him.
You've done more than attain glory, duelist. You've saved the entire bloody world.
We needed a hero, and you rose to the occasion. Thank you.
Welcome.
Greetings.
You are a confusing creature, duelist. Your heart beats for no one but yourself. Yet, you have committed the greatest and most selfless of acts. Was it an act of the heart, or merely an act? Regardless, you may now stride heroically into the sunset. Back to your grand arena. Yes, in Oriath. Upon the mountain high, a gateway has opened. One that shall lead you back home. Hurry, for as the death throes of the beast soften and still, I see the gate beginning to close. Ever pursue your glory, duelist, lest you be forgotten. If Deshret were able, she'd thank you for dispatching her tormentors. Malachi's wicked little trio. You have to content yourself with my thanks instead. Deshret has been avenged, as is the way of the Mardaketh. Tidiness helps one sleep at night, don't you think?
I've met just one other man like you upon this long and twisted thread that is my life. Chittis. A man who understood what it took to give himself absolutely to glory. Yet you and he are different in one tiny little way. Chittis died gloriously. You did not. And now it is my Malachi who is dead. I knew it, felt it, understood it the moment you struck the final blow. I was, the Gemling Queen. And now my king is dead. We dreamed only the greatest dreams, Malachi and I. A truly eternal empire. Eternal life. Eternal love. A future no longer afraid of the past. Eternal lies. Eternal loss. Those are our true gifts to Rayclast. This land could not have asked for a worse king and queen. Rayclast leaves the past behind it now. Malachi's past. My past. It thanks you, not a cockroach. It loves you. I wish that I could do the same.
I was right to have faith in you, Cursebreaker. You have succeeded where we have failed. You have slain a creature that was thought to live forever in the minds of those who came before you. Vol, Dareso, Kaum, Deshret, the greatest champions Rayclast has seen in the last 300 years. You stood where they fell. Now you are the champion of champions, and Rayclast should bow at your feet in gratitude. You certainly have my gratitude, and that of my Akara. We have been exiled from our land by fear and misguided duty.
Now we may return to ride where we will, live how we wish. Cursebreaker, giver of freedom, we thank you.
Harvest is ready at last.
Spirit is spent. I can't do this just yet.
Thank you. Captain Tavares. Altitude is imperative to forging a stable connection with the Prime Resonator in Theopolis. Power source is equally vital. Locate a fissure in the mountainside and lower a conductive cable into it. The deeper, the better. It will take an immense amount of thaumaturgical energy to execute the successful disintegration and transmission of objects, both inanimate and animate, between Highgate and Theopolis. For that kind of power, we must tap the origin. I needn't remind you of the consequences should either of those elements prove deficient. That is why I would like you, Tavares, to be the first to test the resonator once it is operational. Accountability is a perfect counterweight to ambition. High Templar Dominus.